property tax pain. We all feel it. Imagine not having to pay school property taxes each year. There's a proposal at the state capitol to make that a reality. Our report from the 8 on Your Side team is our top story on News 8 at 6. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kim Lemon.
And I'm Brian Roach. We hear about property taxes all of the time at WGAL town meetings. In fact, you asked us to look into this proposal.
And here's what 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger found out.
On a nice day, chances are you'll find Deanna Messimer working outside of her home in Middletown, Dauphin County. She's retired and looking forward to the day she can pay off her mortgage. But there's one home-related expense she says will never be paid in full, the property tax she pays to fund schools.
It's all put on the burden of the homeowner, and that is not fair. It's an unfair tax.
The promise of having her bill reduced or even eliminated is something she's heard before. Pennsylvania lawmakers legalized casino gambling in 2004, first slot machines and later table games, on the promise profit would help offset school property tax bills. But the average reduction, at about $200 a year, has left many taxpayers, like Deanna, wondering if there's a better way.
It's not the fact that I resent paying for schools, because everybody should. It's our future, the education of our children. But I do resent it when I don't think it's being dished out fairly.
People in Pennsylvania are literally suffering under the tyranny of property taxes.
David Baldinger with the Pennsylvania Coalition of Taxpayers has spent the past 2 years at the state capitol urging lawmakers to support what he believes is the answer.
The solution is to completely eliminate the school property tax.
And he's making progress. House Bill 1776, which has bipartisan support, would replace funding schools by property taxes with a combination of raising the sales tax from 6% to 7% and increasing the personal income tax about 1%. To bring in enough money, items you don't pay sales tax on now, like food and clothing items over $50, would be subject to the 7% sales tax. As for criticism, that change would hurt low-income families.
So let's not forget, low-income people own homes too, and they're going to see that property tax burden lifted.
But there are other questions lawmakers are weighing as they look at this proposal. How will changing what is taxed affect people's shopping habits? What happens to funding for schools if sales tax revenues decline? And would raising some taxes to offset another be a violation of Governor Tom Corbett's no tax increase pledge?
It's fair to say it's an elimination bill, but it's not a total elimination immediately.
David DeVar with the Pennsylvania School Boards Association has another concern. He says even if the plan passes, some school districts would still be able to levy property taxes if they have pre-existing debt, like a construction loan, potentially for years until that debt is paid. The PSBA estimates as many as 479 of Pennsylvania's 500 school districts fall into this category and could continue taxing residents.
It's like a mortgage, and it's going to last the 20 or 30 years unless there's some concerted effort to refinance or pay off early.
I don't think they really relate to the average person.
But for homeowners like Deanna Messimer, it would still mean at least a smaller property tax bill, and it's a change she says state leaders should make.
It's giving everybody the responsibility of paying for the educational system.
Even if it means you'll have to pay tax on food, which you haven't had to do.
Right, even if I have to pay some tax on food, because it's going to be more evenly divided.
I'm Matt Belanger, on Your Side, News 8.
Now, some items would still be exempt from the sales tax under the plan, like gasoline, prescriptions, and medical supplies. It is important to remember this plan only impacts school property tax. Property owners would still have to pay county and local property taxes.